Hi, I'm Madison Spahn, and if you were anywhere around the Lamb Theater during the early 2000s, you likely would have seen a smaller version of me running around the halls dreaming of being a Broadway star. And that is why I'm so honored to be part of this fundraiser for the Lamb, because starting with my very first performance in Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat at the age of 4, the Lamb became a second home for me, and Russ and Diana Woolley became like a second family. And though I may not be exactly where I thought I would be as that little kid, I know that their guidance and the opportunity to be at the Lamb has shaped me as an artist, as a musician, and as a person in more ways than I can possibly say. And I am so grateful because I know that when the Lamb moves to their next big location, they're going to continue embracing and lifting up young theater artists like me.
Every day they shout and scold and go about their lives. Heedless of the gift it is to be them. If I were in their skin, I'd treasure every instant out there.
I'll keep on dreaming because I still believe. I still believe in love and me and you. I still believe in love.
It's just my costume, but I'm a wizard every day.
Selena Fisher here, coming to you from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. I grew up in Sioux City, and Lamb was a big part of my childhood. I first joined the summer theater camp with Lamb University 27 years ago. I was 9 years old when my love of the theater began. I attended Lamb summer camp for several summers and became an instructor in my teen years. Getting the chance to gain my own independence as a young kid and teen at Lamb was a huge part of who I've become today. It's taught me the importance of teamwork, community, and the confidence to share my art and go out there and make opportunities for myself.
Break it down, girl, I must warn you. I sense something strange in my mind. The situation is serious. Let's cure it cause we're running out of time.
I love being involved with the Lamb Theatre. I've been doing that for 30 years now. And I really like that it's a community-based theatre, which means that the people on stage and in the audience are all from our community. You know, when you watch a show on the Lamb stage, you get a chance to look at, think about, and respond to issues that impact our community, whether in the past or currently. I also love what Lamb does with kids. You know, research has shown us for a long time now that being involved in a live theater production super enhances the learning outcomes for kids. Well, think about it. When you're on stage, You have to speak clearly and thoughtfully. You have to listen. You have to be an on-the-spot problem solver. You have to make a commitment and accept responsibility, learn how to work with others, and respect others. I mean, these are characteristics that everyone needs to work on. It's super for kids. No, I don't think you can lose by getting involved with the LAM Theater. So I hope to see you there soon.
It is such a pleasure to be with you all today. My name is Chase Shoemaker, and next year I will be taking the position of vocal music director at Bettendorf High School in Bettendorf, Iowa. Until then, I'm currently completing my Master of Music in Choral Conducting from Portland State University. All of this to say that I would not be where I am today without the love and support that I received in my youth from LAM Theater. Tonight, I will be performing Lost in the Wilderness from Children of Eden, and as I was reflecting on my time at LAM, some of the text from Lost in the Wilderness really came to mind. The first being that LAM was one of those little pieces of Eden that I was able to have during my youth. And I still reflect on what a blessing it was to grow up as a gay youth in such a loving and supporting community such as LAM Theater. And now, leading on in music education, my hope is that I will be able to provide a place similar to what LAM provided me, which is a place where I felt like I was found.
I never made this world. I didn't even lose it.
I'm Bill Russell in my apartment in New York City with posters of musicals I've written behind me. One of those is Pageant, which I had the great pleasure of directing at the LAM Theater in 2019. That was a wonderful experience, my first with the LAM, and I certainly hope not my last. I could not have been more supported by Russell Woolley and everyone at the theater. We assembled a great cast and creative team, and the whole experience was a treat for me. The LAM has been a Sioux City institution for over 40 years, and this project is a thrilling new chapter for bringing dynamic theater to the community.
Changes soul, giving hope. And now we present our mother's testimony.
My name is Ilya Yasevich, and I'm so happy to be able to talk to you a little bit today about the impact that LAM Theater has had on my life, and thereby also even on my children's lives, although we live in Kenya now. Where we wish there was LAM Theater, and we're envious of Sioux City for having an amazing gift such as LAM. You know, first got involved with LAM, and you know was being directed in shows through for many years by both Diana and by Russ. Who really led all of us, and even us children, with passion and love, total love and joy and compassion, but also with drive, and would push us, and you know really believed in. Seeing how to really bring out the best, you know, in us. And I was involved in many of the adult shows. but also in the summer program, the kids' summer program as well. This was long before, I think, what later became Lamb University and things, much after my years in Sioux City. And what was at the time also the beginning of the Hot Dog Theater for Kids, where we would serve hot dogs and chips and did amazing shows along with my beautiful colleague, Chad Jacobson, who was the other kind of like child duo in crime there. I remember doing so many, The Boy Who Talked to Whales and other shows. So my years with Lamb, I can say, were very magical, very inspirational, and very, very critical. And the other thing that I want to say, I hope I'm not taking too much time, but the other thing I want to say is that I'm really also struck in hearing a number of other people talk about the impact that Lamb and that theater has had and that the Lamb community has had on their lives, one of the things that strikes me so much is not only about the joy of theater and, you know, the shows and the performances and everything, but how the theater and how Lamb in particular has been a safe place for so many of us who, now I'm getting emotional and goosebumpy, but who have gone through some very, very difficult times in our lives, either as adults or as kids or youth, and who have found a much needed safe refuge, safe place at Lamb. And that is directly because of the work of Diana and Russ and the amazing community of people that they have brought together. And, you know, I'm a psychologist and, you know, run a mental health and organization that works with, you know, things related to trauma and stress and violence and abuse and these kinds of things. And, you know, some of the most critical things that we talk about are, you know, having our sense of safety and security, both physically and mentally and emotionally, and also in our relationships. And for many, I think many of us who have been involved in Lamb over the years and have gone through a lot of different things in our lives, Lamb has been a critical kind of place for people to come together, to be held, to be nurtured, to feel inspired, and to regenerate hope and confidence and our sense of identity and belonging, and to belong to a community, and that's huge. That's huge. That's even more than the amazing shows, you know, that people enjoy that come out of this. But it's really the community building, the life-changing impact that this particular theater has had through all of the community engagement and all of the children and adolescent programming that has happened over the years. And I am so thankful to have been able to be a part of that for a number of years, all of my growing up, really. And I know that I would not be who I am today or be doing the work that I am doing today if it wasn't for the impact of Lamb, Lamb Productions, and Diana and Russ.
Hi, I'm Steven Dolganoff. I live in New York City, and I have had the pleasure since about 2007 of having my work associated with the Lamb Theater. Back then, the Lamb chose to do a licensed production of my musical Thrill Me, and I found out about it because they were one of the very first companies outside of New York to get the rights. So I was so happy, and I contacted them, and they were so incredibly generous. Russ, Diana, the cast, the staff, everyone at Lamb. Their production was spectacular. Sadly, I only got to see little pieces of it because I wasn't able to travel to Iowa. But it was only the beginning, because over the next few years, the Lamb produced the world premieres of my next three musicals, Panic, Flames, and Monster Makers. Those productions were the template for every version moving forward. The shows have now been done in Shanghai, London, Korea, all over the United States, but they all started at the Lamb Theater under the direction of the incredible Russell Woolley. So just knowing how much the Lamb was willing to invest in me makes me realize how much I have the desire to invest in the Lamb moving forward. I hope everyone that gets to attend productions at the Lamb or streaming shows at the Lamb or take classes at the Lamb realize just how lucky you are, because there isn't a lot of theater like this left. So it is extremely important that all of us keep the Lamb in our hearts, support the Lamb, and enjoy the Lamb.
I am Tracy Kern. My first theater home was Lamb Productions Theater many, many moons ago. I was a student at the University of South Dakota, and I had some friends talk me into doing an audition for Lamb's upcoming show, and I got in, and it was Evita, as I said, a long time ago. And I sure enjoyed my 4 years I spent on stage at Lamb doing shows, and I learned so much, and I owe so much of what I know to my beginings with Russ and Diana and everyone at Lamb Theater. Let me go to Never Never Land. Let me fly for one day. Throw that fairy dust in my hair so I pretend I'm flying away. To my surprise, I grew up too fast, and that easy life of Tinkerbell, it never did last. So I'd silently dream myself far, far away, where I could be immortalized like Peter one day. And that's my childhood as I recall, though in some ways it never did end. And now I'm standing, well, a little bit taller.
Hi there. My name is Sean Grennan. I'm talking to you from Pennsylvania right now, where a little cottage that my wife and I have. I usually live in New York, but we're out here to run away and hide. You may not know my face at all, I understand that, but you may have seen some of the plays I've written. I believe Lamb's Theater has done 4 of them. I believe they did Married Alive, Making God Laugh, The Tin Woman, and Now and Then. I hope you enjoyed the show. If you don't, I don't want to hear about it. Shut up. You're not getting your money back. No refunds. Anyway, I had the privilege of coming into Sioux City a couple of years ago and looking around and going down to see the space that they're working on, and it's wonderful. It's a great space. It's, when it's all done, it's going to be such a kind of a tentpole place. It'll be so good for, I think it'll be good for the area. It'll be good for restaurants that people go to before they go to the show, and parking, and perhaps a bar for a drink afterwards, and maybe they want to do some shopping downtown before, that kind of thing. I think it's going to be a very, very nice thing.
Hello, my name is Nathan Halverson, and I currently reside in Colorado Springs, where I am the Associate Director of Performing Arts and Director of Theater Education at the Colorado Springs Fine Arts Center at Colorado College. But before that, I was a young, creative kid who lived in Sioux City who wanted to be an actor. I was so fortunate to spend my formative years at LAM learning and doing shows and taking classes and igniting the passion for this magical thing that we call theater. Theater is a place for collective breath, for deepened empathy, for shared humanity, and you are so lucky to have LAM right there for you to experience. One of my favorite experiences there was Androcles and the Lion. Yes, this is actually my script from that show that we did, I'm thinking, almost 30 years ago. A couple years back, I programmed this particular play to play on our stages for our community because I had experienced such a magical, rich experience doing it in Sioux City. It was a true full circle moment, and I was so proud and happy to do the show here.
If happy little blue